Hi everyone, I'm Mr. Riedel. Welcome to the WeekLEE News. Today is Star Wars Day.
May the Force be with you.
May the Fourth be with you. Our first segment is from our principal, Ms. Heikkila. She has important news about signing up for electives next year. Take a look.
Hey guys, good morning. It's me, your principal, Ms. Heikkila, with an important announcement for students in grades 6 and 7. Please look for an email from me with a link to a form that I need you to fill out. The form will let you tell us what elective classes you want to take in the fall. Your advisory teacher will also have the link on their Schoology page. Please take care of filling this out as soon as you can because I really need the information. It will help me make the schedule for the fall. We want you guys to know that we miss you very much. We really wish we could see you in person, and we look forward to working with you as soon as we can. You please email me or send me a remind message if you need anything or have any questions. Thanks, guys. Take care. Bye.
Next up is our teacher spotlight. This week, we're going to learn a little bit more about Ms. Drummond. Mr. Incavo interviewed her, and Mr. Jim and Steve Anderson added some fun animations. Check it out.
It's time once again to... Your interviewer, Mr. Incavo. In the spotlight, Ms. Drummond.
Going good. Just hanging out with my family and enjoying time with my son, enjoying the outdoors. It's a good time.
My first question is, what are the three things you would spend your money on?
Buy a ranger to go out and look for antlers in the forest, which that's really helpful to have. And it's just fun.
And what?
Do one giant family vacation.
Nice.
With everybody.
That's awesome.
Save the rest of it until something good comes along.
What are some of the things that you miss about school?
I'm having a set routine. That's always nice to have. But seeing everyone's faces, my students, I only have 4 classes, so I've got to spend a lot of time with them.
I get that. And I'm sure kids want to know, do you have a TikTok?
I do not have a TikTok. I have been in a student's TikTok.
Very cool.
And it was very awkward and they just made fun of me.
Awesome. What is your snack of choice these days?
I love nachos.
Nachos. And what?
Brownies.
Nachos and brownies. Thank you, Ms. Drummond. I appreciate you taking your time. I'm looking forward to seeing you soon.
Hopefully soon too.
Take care.
That's it.
Our third segment is the Counselor's Corner with Ms. Mejia and Mr. R.
Hi again, Hawks. It's Ms. Mejia.
And Mr. R.
And welcome back to the Counselor's Corner. Last week we had a Counselor's Challenge which focused on kindness. We asked you to do one kind thing for someone else and one kind thing for yourself. We were really excited to hear from lots of you about all the kind things that you did. So thanks for getting in touch with us. One example of something kind for someone else, a student told us that they helped their parents cook dinner, which is really great. One kind thing another student did for themselves was put down their phone and instead of playing games all afternoon, they went outside and played with their younger sibling. Those are two really great examples of being kind. So that being said, Mr. R, what's this week's topic?
This week's topic is going to be wellness, which means taking care of yourself. Sometimes when we're feeling stressed or frustrated or anxious, our heart rate gets up or our hands get sweaty. So one thing that we can do to practice, you know, bringing in our heart rates down or to calm ourselves down is to practice taking deep. One example of what we're going to show is called the 3-second breath. So you're going to be inhaling for 3 seconds. And then you hold for 3, and then you exhale for 3. And then you practice this as many times as you need to until your heart rate slows down or your body starts to feel like it's more calm.
Well, breathing is a really good exercise to help us in the moment when we feel that heartbeat going up. Sometimes we need more support than just breathing. Sometimes we're going through a really difficult time. Right now, especially, things can feel really extra stressful. And we just need someone to talk to. We're really lucky because at HBLEE, we get to work with someone whose name is Shannon, and she's a therapist. What that means is she offers help to you confidentially around all the things that might be stressing out or the things that you don't know how to handle. especially in middle school, sometimes we have emotions that we don't understand and we really can't control. So you can work with Shannon and she helps you develop all kinds of tools and different techniques to help you know what you can do in that moment where you don't feel like you're in control. She's also just a really great person to talk to about something that happened today that maybe is really frustrating you. All right, Mr. R, what is this week's counselor's challenge?
So for this week's challenge, we're gonna be practicing the 3-second breath. Find a time when you're feeling calm and practice breathing in and breathing out. That way, whenever you're starting to feel stressed out or you're feeling anxious or frustrated, you can use that as a calming technique. Even if it doesn't work the very first time, keep trying it because eventually you'll find a breathing technique that works for you. So that's for this week's counselor challenge. Back to you, Mr. Riedel.
Thanks, Mr. R. The 3-second breath strategy is a really great idea. And I've got to say that we might need to use that 3-second breath strategy for this next bit of news. Here is Mrs. EY with a big announcement.
Good morning, Hawks. This is Mrs. EY reporting from my backyard, where I've been spending a lot of time lately. I love spring because of the changes that occur. The flowers are in bloom, birds are chirping happily, and the weather gets warmer. While sometimes change is beautiful and peaceful, other times it can be uncomfortable. We can be nervous and anxious about it, but it's a necessary part of life. Change is how we learn and grow, how we stretch ourselves beyond what we already know. Change means being outside of your comfort zone, which is where I encourage my students to be once in a while, because taking healthy risk is vital to our development as humans. I'm talking to you about change because I'm about to embark on a new journey of my own. I've accepted a position as principal of St. Therese School and will begin my new job this summer. I never planned to leave HBLEE. I love this school with all my heart, just as I love all of you. But I teach leadership, and leaders need to answer the call to serve. This is how I'm going to serve next. It's new and exciting, and I'm very nervous. But what kind of teacher or leader would I be if I didn't do what I always tell my students to do? It's time for me to step out of my comfort zone and take a healthy risk as principal in a new school. I will miss you. I miss you already. I know you will continue to grow. You will work hard to continue our Hawk traditions. But please do me a favor. Take care of each other, work hard, and don't forget our motto. Once a Hawk, always a Hawk.
We are going to miss you so much, EY. Thank you for your time at HBLEE, and especially for your love for the students. We know that you will be an awesome principal at your school next year. Best wishes to you, and remember that you will always be a part of the HBLEE family. And to all the students out there who know Miss EY and love her, be sure to send her a message so that she knows how much she means to you. And now, on to our student photos segment. It's going to be a little different this week since we asked students to create their own funny Star Wars meme. You all came up with some good ones. Enjoy. Thanks so much to all of you who contributed memes. Those were hilarious. As you take care of your responsibilities this week, some of them might seem difficult and might make you want to say, I have a bad feeling about this.
I have a very bad feeling about this.
I got a bad feeling about this.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Happy beats here, buddy, come on.
However, all the teachers here at HBLEE believe in you. And even if we can't be with you in person, remember, the Force will be with you always.
The Force will be with you, always.
The Force will be with you, always.
Thanks for watching another episode of The WeekLEE News, and make it a great week, Cox.
All right, I'll give it a try.
No, try not. Do or do not. There is no try.